This video deals with the second part of fifth module of web technologies that deals with the JSON. We'll be learning the overview, syntax, data types, objects and schema of JSON. So JSON is the JavaScript object notation. It is a similar lightweight interchange data interchange format as XML. It is a syntax for storing and exchanging data. It is text-based and it is written using JavaScript object notation. The features are like it is minimal, that is, it is self-describing and easy to understand, and it is language independent. We can use it in any programming languages, and also it is very easy to parse. These are the features of JSON. When exchanging data between browser and a server, the data can only be text. So the advantage of JSON is that JSON is text, so it can convert any JavaScript object to JSON, send JSON to the server, and convert the JSON received from the server back to JavaScript object. So it is very easy to handle, and no complicated parsing and translations are there. Other features like it's use the character encoding, Unicode, UTF-8 encoding, and JSON has no version number, no revisions to the JSON grammar is anticipated. JSON is very stable. Moving on to the syntax rules, the syntax of JSON is derived from JavaScript object notation. We can have name value pairs. That is the main difference between XML and JSON. So JSON names require double quotes, but JavaScript does not. So this is how you declare a variable in JSON. So name, that is incorporated in double quotes, and the value will be given like this. It is separated by a colon. Age is again another variable. It is having a numerical value. If it is a numerical value, there is no need to include it within double quotes. Only the name of the variable is to be in double quotes. Then colon value. So this is how you declare value. Instead of equal to, you have to just write colon value. Data is separated by comma. Curly braces hold objects. If you want to create an object, it is like this. Within curly braces, you have to give name value pairs. So this is an object which contains two values, name and age. We can access the object using dot operator as in any other JavaScript and all. So my object dot name, that will be the first object name, and my object dot age is the second object name. Square brackets are used to hold arrays in JSON. So just write square bracket and give the name of the array within double quotes. So this is the name of the array given. And after colon, you have to give the values of the array within square brackets. So this is the format of creating an array in JSON. Within quotes, you have to give the values one by one. And this also can be accessed similar to the regular array access mechanism. Users 0, that will be accessing the value John. Users of 1 will be accessing the value Delma, etc. That is how you declare variables. Variables are declared just by using name value pairs. Objects are declared by using curly braces, and square brackets hold arrays. Just give within braces, you have to give the name of the array. After colon, you have to give the within square bracket, you have to give the values of the array. Finally, close the curly braces and it ends with a semicolon. Moving on to JSON values or data types. The values must be of one of the following types. These are the data types in JSON. It can be a string, number, object, array, boolean or null. The files in JSON are saved with .json notation, and the MIME type for JSON is application/JSON. Moving on to the different data types. String type. String types contains a string as its value. So name, colon, John. So this is a string data, and it is generally wrapped in double quotes. There is no separate character data types in JSON also. Now Moving to numbers, numbers can be integer or floating or real values. Age 30. So you can give the numbers as values like this. No octal or hex values permitted, no NaN or infinity. Boolean values in JSON can be true or false. This is how you give the value. So there is no double quotes here. True is a data type. Sale, true. Null means a value that isn't anything. Objects are unordered containers having key value pairs. They are wrapped in curly braces. Comma separator is used to separate the key value pairs. Colon separates the key from its value, and the keys are generally strings. So this is an example, employee object. Employee is equal to, within curly braces, you have to give the name value pairs, name equal to John. After that, comma separates the next item. So age 30, city New York. So it is accessed by dot notation, employee.name, employee.age, or employee.city. This is how objects are created and accessed in JSON. Now moving on to arrays. Arrays are ordered sequences of values. They are wrapped in square bracket, as we have told earlier. And comma is used as a separator for values. And this is an example. Within braces, you have to write it. So this is how you write array. And now you have to give the name of array like this, within double quotes. Then add a colon and then start the square bracket to give the values one by one within comma separate format. You can access it using the index. Indexing start normally at zero itself. JSON schema can be written. It is a vocabulary that allows user to annotate and validate JSON documents, like what we have XML schema for validating an XML document. So the JSON document being validated or described is called the instance, like the XML instance, and the document containing the description is called the schema. JSON schema is again a rule file which describes the existing data format. It is very clear, human and machine readable documentation. Complete structural validation can be done using JSON schema for validating the client submitted data. And there are several schema validators available in different programming languages. This is an example of JSON schema. It is quite different from XML schema. Within curly braces, we include the schema. Dollar schema, that is a name, and we have to give the schema namespace or identifier here. Then you have to give title employee. So I'm defining the data employee, so the title should be employee. The type is object. Description, employee details, and I have to give the properties one by one. This is the ID. ID is a description and it defines a unique employee ID, and the type is integer. Name, type is equal to string. Age is another value. Description, age in years, and type is equal to integer. Minimum 0. So like what we have given, some facets and all we have given in XML, we can give the minimum value, minimum colon 0. Description describes what it is, and type describes what is the data type. And finally, what are the required parameters? ID and name. Age can be omitted. These are the required parameters. That is the meaning of required. So this is a description of the keywords. Dollar schema keywords state that the schema is written according to the draft 06 specification. Title and description keywords are used to state the intent of the schema. Why we write the schema? They are descriptive only. They do not add constraints to the data. They are just adding meaning to what it does. The type keyword defines the data type. It can be any of the JSON data types. And defining the properties, it describes the keys and their values one by one, giving a description and the data type. And it also specifies whether it is required or not. That is a description of JSON schema. We need to study only the basics. These are the similarities between JSON and XML. JSON is like XML because it is self-describing. It is human readable. Both are hierarchical. Both are interoperable and language independent. Both can be parsed and used by a lot of programming languages. And both XML and JSON can be fetched with an XML HTTP request. They can be used to receive data from a web server, and both supports Unicode character set. These are the differences between JSON and XML schema. JSON doesn't use N tag. JSON is very shorter than XML. JSON is quicker to read, that means machine reading is quite faster. JSON can use arrays, but there is no array concept in XML. The biggest difference why JSON is better than XML, of course JSON is better. Maybe get a question, which is better, JSON or XML? Of course JSON is better because XML can be parsed only with an XML parser and it is taking more time. But JSON can be parsed by standard JavaScript function. So it is quite easier. This is a comparison. JSON is JavaScript object notation while XML is extensible markup language. In JSON, there is no markup. It does not affect any display capabilities. XML is doesn't provide any display capabilities. JSON is XML is markup. It provides display capabilities by the browser. JSON support array. XML doesn't support array. JSON is less secured. XML is more secured. But coming to parsing, JSON is faster while XML is slower. JSON is quite simple. It use less verbose, use only the necessary text. XML uses more words than necessary. JSON support only text and number data types. XML support many other data types like image, graph, etc. as binary types, references. And JSON, there is no concept of namespaces. Context resolves the ambiguity. XML has namespaces, resolves ambiguity. No validator, languages validate by itself. XML has XML validators. This is a comparison of JSON and XML. One simple example to show how simpler is JSON than XML. So first we will go see through the XML part. So I have an employees tag. Within that I have different employee tags. This is a structured XML. First name John and last name Doe. The same data can be represented in JSON in such a simple format as a JSON array. Employees is the name of the array, colon, square bracket. We can give first name John, last name Doe, and first name Anna, last name Smith. So all these can be added as indexed array. And that means key value pairs, associative array, and then close the square bracket and this. So this representation is much simpler and easy to understand than the XML notation. That is the biggest advantage. These are some of the advantages of using JSON. So we have learned the basic syntax, data types, objects and schema in JSON, and we compared it with XML. And finally, we have learned to utilize XML and JSON information interchange formats for information exchange between different systems. These are the references for the JSON part. Thank you.